In this video, we will be learning the shortcut method of multiplying any number by the numbers 0.125, 1.25, 12.5, 125 and so onwards. Okay, so let's get started. Now, the best way of learning mathematics is by solving questions. So, we'll be solving many questions in this lecture. Okay, so let's get started. Now, the first question is 368 into 0.125. Now, this can be written as 368 into 0.125 is actually nothing but 1 by 8. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to divide 368 by 8. So, the method of doing this is we divide 368 by 2 first, thereby getting 184. Then again, we divide 184 by 2, thereby getting 92. And this process has to be repeated one more time. So, we divide 92 by 2, thereby getting 46. Okay, and hence this is the answer. So, in the next question, we have 584 into 1.25. Now, this can be written as 584 into 10 divided by 8. So, we can keep 10 aside for a moment and we can focus upon 584 divided by 8. So, what we need to do is we need to divide 584 by 2 again and again. So, thereby getting 292 divided by 4 into 10. Again, we get 146 divided by 2 into 10. And lastly, we get 73 into 10, thereby giving us the answer as 730. Okay, so let's move on. Now, for the next question, we have 156 into 12.5. This can be written as 156 into 100 by 8. Okay, so what we do is we divide 156 by 8, so we get 78 and again 39 and again 19.5 and we multiply it with the 100, thereby getting the answer as 1950. Okay, and now let us check out the next question. So we have 848 into 125. So this will give us 848 into 1000 divided by 8. So this gives us 106 into 1000. Now this can be done in one step only because 8 is divisible by 8, 48 is divisible by 8. So, 848 when divided by 8 will give us 106 and this can be done mentally, okay? Thereby giving us the answer as 106,000, okay? So, now let us check out the alternative solutions, that is the alternative methods of multiplying by these numbers, okay? See, we have already told you that it is always better to solve a particular question by more than one method. And we'll be solving these questions by an alternative method. So, let's see. Now, we have 584 into 1.25. Now, into 1.25 means 1 plus 0.25. Now, 0.25 is nothing but 1 by 4. So, this is 584 into 1 plus 1 by 4. Therefore, now we have 584 plus 584 divided by 4. So, 584 divided by 4 is actually the same as 292 divided by 2, is actually the same as 146. So, what we do is 584 plus 146, thereby giving us the answer as 730. Okay, so now let's move on. Now, the next question we have 368 into 0.125. Now, this can be written as 368 into 1.25 divided by 10. So, now what we have done is, we have transformed the second question into a similar form of the first question. So, here we have 368 into 1 plus 1 by 4 and into 1 by 10. Okay. So, what we do is, we add 368 plus 368 divided by 4. So, now 368 divided by 4 is actually equal to 92. Therefore, we add 368 and 92 and we divide it by 10. So, thereby getting the answer as 460 divided by 10, and hence the answer is 46. Okay, I hope you have understood this concept. Let's move on. So, the next question is 156 into 12.5. This can be written as 156 into 1.25 into 10. Okay, so this is 1560 into 1 plus 1 by 4. So now 1560, what is 1560 divided by 4? Okay, 1560 divided by 2 is 780. 780 divided by 2 is 390. So all we need to do is, we need to add these numbers, that is 390 and 1560, thereby giving the answer as 1950. Okay, I hope you have understood this. So for the next question, we can write it as 848 into 1.25 into 100. Okay, so we have 84800 into 1 plus 1 by 4. Okay, so this will give us 84800 plus 21200. And adding these two numbers, we get the answer as 106000. I hope you have understood this.